डिस्कस एक्सक्रीशन टॉपिक. व्हाट इज एक्सक्रीशन? एक्सक्रीशन इज अ प्रोसेस ऑफ रिमूवल ऑफ नाइट्रोजिनस वेस्ट. सो व्हाट इज नाइट्रोजिनस वेस्ट? लाइक अमोनिया, यूरिया, यूरिक एसिड दैट इज प्रोड्यूस्ड इन बॉडी. दिस इज रिमूव्ड बाय द प्रोसेस ऑफ एक्सक्रीशन. सो एक्सक्रीशनरी सिस्टम ऑफ ह्यूमन दैट कंटेनिंग वन पेयर ऑफ किडनी. सो किडनी इज लोकेटेड इन थोरेसिक थर्ड लंबर वर्टिब्री. किडनी एंड यूरेटर, यूरिनरी ब्लैडर एंड यूरेथ्रा. सो इन फैक्ट व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ किडनी? किडनी हेल्प इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ यूरिन. व्हाट इज फॉर्म? यूरिन. सो जनरली ऑर्गेनिज्म एक्सक्रीट मटेरियल अकॉर्डिंग टू द अमाउंट ऑफ वाटर, लाइक अमोनोटेलिक, यूरियोटेलिक एंड यूरिकोटेलिक. सो अमोनोटेलिक ऑर्गेनिज्म आर एक्वाटिक ऑर्गेनिज्म लाइक मोस्ट ऑफ द इनवर्टिब्रेट्स एंड टैडपोल. यूरियोटेलिक, सो अमोनिया इज मोस्ट टॉक्सिक. यूरियोटेलिक लाइक मैमल्स एंड अदर टेरेस्ट्रियल वन. एंड यूरिकोटेलिक, यूरिकोटेलिक आर दोज विच लिविंग इन लेस वाटर, दोज हैविंग लेस अमाउंट ऑफ वाटर लाइक इन डिजर्ट, दे आर यूरिकोटेलिक, यूरिक एसिड. सो यूरिक एसिड लाइक बर्ड्स आर सिक्रीटेड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पीलेट दैट इज यूरिक एसिड. And in some insects and desert reptiles, they are uricotelic. So kidney help in the formation of urine. Then this urine are goes into the ureter. Ureter is one pair that is a tube-like structure which help to transport of urine. Then this urine are stored in urinary bladder. Where it is stored? Urinary bladder, bladder-like structure where urine are stored. And then pass through the urethra. What is urethra? Like we previously discussed, urethra is a common passage both semen and urine. So urethra help in the secretion of passageway of urine. So that is function all about. Then this kidney containing a renal pyramids. What is medullary pyramids? These pyramids containing millions of nephron. So nephron is a structural and functional unit of kidney. So we move to the nephron. So that is a nephron, both of kidney containing millions of nephron. So nephron is look like, so nephron containing two portions, like this portion is Bowman capsule and glomerulus, and another portion is that is called renal tubules. So renal tubules containing PCT, DCT, Henle loops. So how in the nephron our blood is filtered? Because blood is only medium which help in transport the substance, also excretory product are present in the blood. So how blood is filtered? How in the blood nitrogenous waste are removed? We discussed like blood with waste material. Blood with waste material or excretory substance and other important substance like ammonia, urea, glucose, amino acids, water, are come into through afferent arteriole. Afferent arteriole carry the waste blood and nitrogenous blood containing blood. This blood pass and goes to the glomerulus. Glomerulus is a tuft of and highly coiled afferent arteoles which is enclosed inside the Bowman capsule, that is cap like structure which enclose the afferent arteoles that form glomerulus. Then this afferent arteriole, this glomerulus act as a like a filter act as a filter. So those are small molecules, smaller molecules like ammonia, urea, amino acids, sodium, potassium, electrolytes are pass away and reach to the Bowman capsule. And other larger substance like in blood WBC, RBC and protein are not filtered and goes to the afferent arteriole to the body parts. Then this filtrate containing different type of substance, mostly similar as a plasma. Mostly these substances are similar as a plasma. Then that is called glomerular filtration, also called blood filtration. That is the first step of urine formation. So in the blood filtration, filtration of the blood intake place through the glomerulus and nitrogenous waste and other electrolyte are filtered through the blood and reach to the next, that is goes to the PCT part. दैट इज कॉल्ड प्रॉक्सिमल कन्वोल्यूटेड ट्यूब्यूल पीसीटी. सो दिस पीसीटी पार्ट कंटेनिंग मेनी मोस्टली ऑफ रीअब्सॉर्प्शन, मोस्टली रीअब्सॉर्प्शन ऑफ वाटर एंड इलेक्ट्रोलाइट्स आर टेक प्लेस थ्रू दिस पार्ट. Mostly the absorption of water and electrolyte are take place to the PCT. Then the important substance like electrolytes, water, glucose, amino acid are reabsorbed and goes to the hairpin like structure called Henle loop. That is a descending, that is a ascending loop of Henle, where rest of the water and electrolytes and important substance are reabsorbed. Then after reabsorption, this goes into the DCT portion, that is called distal convoluted tubule. This distal convoluted tubule help in the secretion of sodium and potassium to maintain the osmolarity of the blood. Then this after this is goes into the collecting duct, right, and form urine. So that form the concentrated urine, and collecting duct also help in the reabsorption of water. So some parts are reabsorbed by reabsorption of water take place, some parts does not reabsorb water. So that form you can urine and then goes into the ureter, urinary bladder and release out. That is a function of formation of urine. So that having three step. First step, glomerular filtration or blood filtration, that is take place in glomerulus. Second step is a reabsorption of substance that take place in different PCT and Henle loop. And third step is selective secretion that takes place in DCT part. So that is a three process that help in the formation of urine. So that two very important. And then next we move to the phenomenon that is called hemodialysis. What is hemodialysis? The person which kidney failed to perform proper function, they undergo for the hemodialysis. Because kidney function to filter the blood and remove the nitrogenous waste from the body. So if your kidney is damaged and not work properly, then this patient undergo for the hemodialysis and provide an artificial kidney for the filtration of blood. That is process is called hemodialysis. So that life process chapter unit is complete. Make the proper notes.